When performing linear regression, we have a number of data points. Let's say that we have 1, 2, 3, and so on, up through m data points. Each data point has an output variable, y, and a number of input variables, x1 through xn. So in our baseball example, y is the lifetime number of home runs, and our x1 and xn are things like height and weight. Our 1 through m samples might be different baseball players. So maybe data point 1 is Derek Jeter, data point 2 is Barry Bonds, and data point m is Babe Ruth. Generally speaking, we are trying to predict the values of the output variable for each data point by multiplying the input variables by some set of coefficients that we're going to call theta 1 through theta n. Each theta, which we'll from here on out call the parameters or the weights of the model, tell us how important an input variable is when predicting a value for the output variable. So if theta 1 is very small, x1 must not be very important in general when predicting y. Whereas if theta n is very large, then xn is generally a big contributor to the value of y. This model is built in such a way that we can multiply each x by the corresponding theta and sum them up to get y, so that our final equation will look something like the equation down here. Theta 1 plus x1 plus theta 2 times x2 all the way up to theta n plus xn equals y. And we'd want to be able to predict y for each of our m data points. In this illustration, the dark blue points represent our observed data points, whereas the green line shows the predicted value of y for every value of x given the model that we may have created. The best equation is the one that's going to minimize the difference across all data points between our predicted y and our observed y. What we need to do is find the thetas that produce the best predictions, that is, making these differences as small as possible. If we wanted to create a value that describes the total errors of our model, we'd probably sum up the errors, that is, sum over all of our data points from I equals 1 to m, the predicted y minus the actual y. However, since these errors can be both negative and positive, if we simply sum them up, we could have a total error term that's very close to zero, even if our model is very wrong. In order to correct this, rather than simply adding up the error terms, we're going to add up the square of the error terms. This guarantees that the magnitude of each individual error term, y predicted minus y actual, is positive. Why don't we make sure the distinction between input variables and output variables is clear?